Let us begin with prayers to Ma Sharda. Again, today's journey. Yesterday we discussed electric field. Okay, we will have a quick revision of it, dear students, and then we will discuss new topic on it. Okay. So first of all, what is electric field? Okay. Each and every charge has its effect surrounding it. Okay, and that effect is called electric field, and it is measured in terms of electric field intensity. Okay, see, as I speak, okay, my sound produced by me can reach up to certain area, that is called field of my sound. Okay, field of my voice, whatever you say. Similarly, a charge can offer electric force up to some area, that is called its electric field, and it is measured in terms of electric field intensity. Okay, sometimes both are considered as equal. Okay, because electric field is not visible, so it can be measured only in terms of intensity. Okay, now let us have a quick revision of yesterday's topic, dear students. This is our positive capital Q charge. Okay, and in its electric field at position vector r, we have placed another point like charge, which is like charge, means either both are positive or both are negative, but here we will consider positive. Why positive, that we'll discuss afterwards. Okay, so this small q, so this capital Q will repel this small q, and this is the force vector. Okay, we know that force equals to 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught. In place of Q1, I have written capital Q. In place of Q2, I have written small q. This distance is r square, and this is the direction. So I have to just write here unit vector, that is r cap. That is unit vector in direction of vector r. Okay. Now if I divide this by small q, okay, then it gives us the electric field intensity. Okay. So this small q divided, so here it will be electric field intensity will be equal to 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught, only capital Q remaining, upon r square into r cap. Okay, so that, what is definition? Definition of electric field intensity is force on unit charge at a given point by a source charge is called electric field intensity at that point by that source charge. Okay, again, force on a unit positive charge by a source charge at a given point is electric field intensity at that point by source charge. Okay, now what will be its dimensional formula? So force is m1 l1 t minus 2, charge is ampere into time, so finally it is m1 l1 t minus 3 a minus 1. Its unit is newton per coulomb or volt per meter. Okay, now today's topic. What are the characteristics of electric field intensity? What are the characteristics? Okay, special things about electric field intensity or electric field. Okay, so first, see, this is called source charge. Okay, the charge which produces electric field is called source charge, and the charge which checks how much is the effect is called test charge. Here small q is test charge, capital Q is source charge. Now we know that if you are appearing in an exam and I am a supervisor, okay, then I must keep silence. Okay, if I go on speaking, then you will be disturbed. Similarly here, this small q must not have any effect on source of capital Q. Small q, that is test charge, must not have any effect on field of source charge capital Q. So test charge should be as minimum as possible. So ideal definition of electric field intensity is limit Q tends to 0 vector F upon Q. Q must be as small as possible. Okay, keep mum when others are appearing in exam. This is for supervisors. Okay, now but see, this is ideal definition of electric field intensity. Why ideal? Because according to quantization of electric charge, the minimum available charge in free condition is small, not less than that free charge is yet available. That is why this is ideal definition. Good, but ideal. Okay. Now we know that in this case, the electric field produced by capital Q must be independent of small q.
Okay?
Because E equals to F upon Q. So in equation of E, small q is not appearing. So E is independent of test charge small q. The vector E, that is electric field, exists at every point in three-dimensional space. Means, suppose this is a point charge, okay? If I put a positive charge here, there will be electric field. Here, electric field. Here, electric field. In three dimensions, it exists at every point. Okay? Then, third point. For point like positive charge, as positive charge offer repulsive force to another positive charge, the effect is outward. Okay? Radially outward. Radially outward. And for negative charge, it is radially inward. Inward means this is negative. If I put here a positive charge, it will attract. So radially inward. This is positive. If I put here a positive charge, it will repel. So outward. Okay? But radial. Okay? Radially outward and radially inward. Moreover, as F is proportional to 1 upon R square, E is also proportional to 1 upon R square. So directly proportional to square of the inversely proportional to square of the distance. Okay? E is proportional to 1 upon R square. Or say directly proportional to R raised to minus 2. Okay? Now, a vector E, due to a point charge, has spherical acceptance. Spherical means, see, here. See, at one, suppose this is a point like charge. At 1 centimeter distance, in any direction, will have equal effect. Okay? Electric field will have equal magnitude at 1 centimeter from source charge to any point, any direction. Okay? So, it is called spherical acceptance. We know that direction of E is direction of F. That is, the direction of electric field is a direction of force on unit positive charge. Okay? And finally, who gave the idea about electric field? Faraday, he was the first to give idea about the electric field.